on One Devotion. The season's first phase points us towards the thrills of the top 16. The players explain the recent profusion of whiskers on the court. The Euroleague's all-time best shot blocker tells us how it's done. And during a short break in the competition, rising stars take the stage. Call it a fashion, or simply a passion, but the number of players sporting beards on court around the Turkish Airlines Euroleague has grown markedly in recent seasons. It's not enough to point out that the competition's last two full-season MVPs, Vasilis Panoulis of Olympiakos Piraeus and Sergio Rodriguez of Real Madrid, are true believers in their whiskers. Another team, Unix Kazan, veterans Kostas Kaimakoglu and Viktor Sanikidze share both the power forward position and a fondness for long beards. But if many players have gone all in for serious facial hair, the decision to stop shaving was different for each.
Personally, I'm like this from when I was very young, 17, 18 years old, so I like it. And I keep it like this, all these things with shaving and this. I'm sensitive in my skin, so it's better like this.
Spanoulis' one-time teammate on the Greek national team, Kaimakoglu, another former EuroLeague champion, was never totally clean-shaven. But he decided to go all in on his beard right before joining Unix.
I always had a beard, but not so long. And when I came in the team, I saw that everybody was interested on the beard, why you have a beard, when you will cut and all this stuff. I started having also fun and I kept it.
This year, Kaimakoglu's beard became suddenly short when compared to the new teammate coming off the bench to replace him.
I had my last shave last year before New Year, so I just said to myself that I was not going to shave for the whole year. And my teammates were very curious that they said that I would have cut it. It's always funny and everybody just joking around about your beard, and also back in my home, Georgia.
Kaimakoglu knows of what he speaks when he says that Sanikidze has the better chops.
For sure, Viktor has the best one because it's the longest one.
Still, Kaimakoglu can look around the league with pride in his own beard and talk some trash.
Especially with my friend Vasilis, that from last season when I grew longer beard, I started making fun of him, that hey, Vasilis, now I have a longer beard, you know, stuff like this.
Competitive though he may be, the three-time EuroLeague champ refuses to join the battle of the beards.
For sure, I can tell you that I can imagine that the biggest one is of Kostas Kaimakoglu or Sergio Rodriguez. I think it's a battle between them.
Spanoulis, however, is not above challenging another Unix player and the best man at his wedding, Nikos Zizis.
Nikos and beard don't go together. You know, Nikos, even if he will be 10 years without shaving, he will not have beard, maybe a little bit moustache or something like that.
But Kaimakoglu is quick to defend Zizis.
The last 2 years, we're teammates too in Unix, and we are roommates too. He tries, but he cannot grow a beard. He doesn't want also to have a beard. It's his style.
But if beards are a fashion for some stars...
Maybe just one day I'm going to wake up and just shave it all.
They are certainly a passion for others, who won't take up razors again, even if they win the EuroLeague.
No, that's unacceptable. I like how I look with the beard, and it's not just a superstition that if we win something, I will cut. So I will keep it, even if we win.
comes to protecting his team's basket, Fran Vasquez has been the best of the best over the course of his Turkish Airlines EuroLeague career. The Unicaja Malaga center is the competition's all-time blocks leader, having rejected 229 shooters who came too close to him over the years. His reputation for returning shots from whence they came started with Vasquez's EuroLeague debut for Unicaja way back in 2002.
Estar en, fichar en Málaga, pues la verdad que bueno, la oportunidad de entrenar por los primeros días con el primer equipo a las órdenes de Bosnia Markovic, la verdad que me ha ayudado mucho, ¿no? Y ahora pues la oportunidad que me ha dado de aprender pues forma de jugar, la forma de desarrollar mi juego, pues la verdad que me queda con esa sensación de positiva.
Getting his first taste of the EuroLeague at 18 years old was an inspiring experience for the young Vasquez.
Un jugador con esa edad, pues con 18 años, mantener el primer equipo, jugar contra los mejores equipos de Europa, pues siempre es una motivación extra.
Soon, Vasquez arrived to Barcelona, where he spent the next six seasons ruling the paint as a feared rejectionist and breaking the EuroLeague record for career blocks early in 2010.
Es un orgullo estar en esa lista de, en este caso, de máximos taponadores, de superando a jugadores históricos, ¿no? Yo me acuerdo que cuando batía récord, pasé el primero, que era Denis McCornato, pues me enfrentaba contra él. Y la verdad que bueno, fue un partido especial.
Later the same season, his successful run in Barcelona reached a pinnacle when Vasquez and his teammates lifted the EuroLeague trophy at the 2010 Final Four in Paris after defeating Olympiacos Piraeus in the championship game.
No me lo esperaba, ¿no? Jugamos, creo que el primer partido CSK, creo que era, y pues era Olympiacos. La verdad que era complicado, ¿no? Años anteriores que hemos ido, pues Olympiacos no había ganado, CSK igualmente, y pues tenía esa cruz, ¿no? De decir, pues bueno, nos enfrentamos aquí, pues que anteriormente nos han eliminado, y bueno, yo creo que esa tranquilidad de decir, bueno, poco a poco, sabemos lo que pasó anteriormente.
Vasquez made doubly sure for Barcelona by registering four blocks against Olympiacos, setting a new championship game record.
La nueva Euroliga, pues la verdad que a cualquier jugador pues es lo máximo que le puede pasar, ¿no? En el sentido pues, de jugar con su club, ¿no? Y la verdad que bueno, de tantos años que llevaba jugando en Euroliga y conseguirla, la verdad que ha sido un efecto positivo para mí, ¿no?
Despite all his accomplishments, Vasquez also rejects too much praise for his shot blocking.
No hay mucho secreto. Yo creo que es un poco de entre mitad suerte y mitad estar en el momento justo, ¿no? Y muchas veces he ido a taponar cinco veces y puede ser que haya taponado una, dos o ninguna, ¿no? Es también un poco de la suerte, ¿no? Pero yo creo que ese era el tiempo, ¿no? El momento justo, pues de cuando ves el jugador que va hacia ganarse, pues está en ese momento oportuno, ¿no? Y no es una cosa como muchos entrenadores o mucha gente pues dice, no, es que eso se entrena. Yo nunca lo he entrenado. La verdad es que es algo que sale naturalmente de mí y ya está.
Now 31 years old, Vasquez holds a large lead, more than 75 blocks, over any player who would challenge his record, even as he keeps adding to that record with every new swat.
Hombre, ojalá sea mucho más.
Now let's see what happened in the last round of the regular season. In Group A, Real Madrid won a battle of group leaders before Nizhny Novgorod and Žalgiris Kaunas dramatically punched the last two tickets to the top 16. The group was clinched by Real Madrid in a direct battle for first place with Anadolu Efes Istanbul, as Ioannis Borussis dominated to earn the weekly B-Win MVP honour. The final two top 16 places were secured in spectacular circumstances, starting when Nizhny Novgorod rallied for a 78-74 home win over Unix Kazan, behind 23 points from Terence Kinsey. That left Unix hoping Žalgiris lost at home, which looked likely as Sassari led their game by 9 midway through the fourth quarter. But then James Anderson took over, tying the game with 2.5 seconds on the clock and hitting a free throw to win it. Group A closed with Real Madrid on top, Efes second, Žalgiris third and Nizhny taking the final qualification spot. In Group B, CSKA Moscow eased to yet another big win. Maccabi made it three in a row and Cedevita Zagreb went out with a bang. CSKA Moscow concluded the competition's only perfect regular season with a commanding home victory over already eliminated Limoges. CSKA hit 14 three-pointers, including four from top scorer Vitali Fridsen, while he and nine teammates all had at least 5 points and one assist in an emphatic all-round team display. Maccabi Electra Tel Aviv leaned on Devin Smith and Jeremy Pargo, who combined for 36 points, to pull away in the final minutes against Unicaja Malaga. But Alba Berlin couldn't take advantage of the opportunity created by Unicaja's loss to climb into third place, as visiting Cedevita Zagreb finished its season on a winning note. CSKA continues undefeated into the top 16, with Maccabi untroubled in second, while Unicaja finished third, just above Alba. FC Barcelona won Group C impressively on the road, despite Fenerbahce winning its sixth in a row and EA7 Milan its third. Barcelona travelled to Athens looking to confirm top spot, and soon established a convincing early lead over Panathinaikos that would never be relinquished, with floor general Marcelinho Huerta scoring a game-high 17 points and dishing 9 assists. Fenerbahce gained its sixth consecutive victory by holding off a spirited challenge from Bayern Munich, as Bogdan Bogdanovic led the way with 16 points. EA7 Milan also maintained its winning streak, claiming its third straight success in a high-scoring encounter against Turov. Linas Klaser was the key man, scoring a career-high 29 points, including a club-record 8 three-pointers. FC Barcelona ended with the regular season's second-best record, with Fenerbahce a comfortable second, while Panathinaikos and Milan also progressed to the top 16. In Group D, Galatasaray vaulted into the top 16 by knocking off the leaders, while Valencia routed Neptunas Klaipeda, while Cervena Zvezda won the battle for second place. Neptunas Klaipeda travelled to Spain, needing a victory to confirm its progression to the top 16, but was simply swept away by Valencia, which got 20 points from Luka Harangodi and 19 for Bojan Dubljevic en route to 103 points. That opened the door for Galatasaray to claim fourth spot, and the Turkish team seized its opportunity as Carlos Arroyo scored 24 points and Patrick Young claimed a double-double to overcome first-place Olympiakos. In another behind-closed-doors encounter, Cervena Zvezda held off Laboral Cucha in a straight fight for second place, with Marcus Williams scoring 23 points. Defeat didn't stop Olympiakos from winning the group, while Cervena Zvezda moved into second above Laboral Cucha, and Galatasaray leapfrogged Neptunas into fourth. Top 16 Group E is showcased by a Spanish Clásico as group winners Real Madrid and Barcelona go head-to-head. One another highlight will be a rematch of last season's final as champions Maccabi Electra take on Madrid. In Group F, 2012's final will also be repeated as CSKA Moscow faces fellow group winner Olympiacos. Laboral Cucha and Unicaja provide another all-Spanish clash, while Anadolu Efes coach Dusan Ivković will go up against his former Olympiacos team. Leo Vesterman and JP Batista of Limoges CSP ask the questions in our one-on-one.
I'm going to start. I have one question for you. You're Brazilian, all right? So I think that everybody want to know why basketball.
I started playing soccer when I was little, but I was too big, started to growing too much, and it was just not for me.
I don't know if you know what's happened in 98, in July 98. No?
No.
No friends, Brazil?
Oh.
1-2-3-0.
Oh, yeah.
Ah, yeah. This I remember.
I don't remember because we have five World Cup trophies.
That's so, not the question.
My turn for you. I know you have a girlfriend from Brazil. She's half Brazilian. Do you know any words in Portuguese?
No. obrigado, and there's this famous cocktail.
Caipirinha.
Caipirinha, that's it.
Curious question, how old were you when you started playing?
My father was a professional basketball player. I'm a basketball baby.
Players that you, from the past and present, that you'd like to see and try to be like them?
I would say Diamantidis, Papaloukas, Jasikevicius and Bodiroga. I love to watch Marcelino Novertas. I mean, this is my third year in Euroleague, and this is the tougher point guard I played against.
Superstitions before the game, do you have any?
I have a little bit, but it's not that much. I heard that some player have crazy routine. Spanoulis from Olympiacos, he has to go first in the bus, something like that. And for you?
I step on the basketball court with my right foot.
This is superstition, man.
That's the only one.
The end-of-year holidays mark a one-week break in the Turkish Airlines EuroLeague schedule. The future stars of the competition are just revving up to battle for glory themselves. The EuroLeague Basketball Adidas Next Generation Tournament will hit the ground running on the last weekend of 2014 and won't stop until a continental junior champion is crowned during the Final Four in Madrid next May. In its 14th season, the tournament has become a global standard in junior basketball as the first international stage for many current EuroLeague stars. Vytenis Lipkevičius, now a four-year veteran with Žalgiris Kaunas, was part of that club's second junior champion back in 2007 in Athens, Greece.
It means everything because, like, when you start playing basketball, you're thinking about play against the best players.
While winning the junior tournament was unforgettable, all the tournament participants enjoy the privilege of a lifetime for any basketball fan, witnessing a Final Four live.
It was something amazing, you know. I was like 17 years old at that moment. You're seeing this Oaka arena, like 20,000 spectators. It was something amazing at this time, you know, thinking about these memories. It means a lot for me because I think one day maybe I will play Final Four. I hope so.
The current EuroLeague B-Win MVP of the month, Dario Saric of Anadolu Efes Istanbul, was MVP of the 2011 junior tournament when his KK Zagreb team won the title in Barcelona.
That tournament helped me to get more experience for basketball, to field against boys who got same year like me, and it was great part of my basketball career, and I'm very proud of myself, of my team.
As all recent junior tournament champions, Saric and his Zagreb teammates received their trophy at halftime of the EuroLeague Championship game in front of a packed arena and a worldwide television audience.
For me, it's a special moment when we come in a court, an EuroLeague game and a final, and to see the so many fans, so many different fans in that time, and it was big experience for me.
For Saric, the lasting impression from that experience remains with him now. He wants to compete at a Final Four someday, just like he did as a junior.
When I came in that gym and I see the fans and I see the five players from each side on the court, I feel like I want to be there. I want to beat one guy of that 10 in the court and play for something big from Europe.
Starting on December 27th, a new crop of teenage talents will get the chance to field just like Saric did. Throughout the winter, 32 teams from 15 countries will compete at Adidas Next Generation qualifying rounds: Rome, Italy; L'Hospitalet, Spain; Kaunas, Lithuania; and Belgrade, Serbia. And the winners from each city will qualify to be in Madrid next spring as future stars taking part already in the biggest weekend in world basketball.
Hello, my name is Filip Dilevic and I will try to learn my friend
Marty Carlos
some Polish words. First of all, and most important for us, is especially for me, that I need to call my friends how to pass me the ball. Podaj mi piłkę. Podaj.
Podaj.
Mi.
Mi.
Piłkę.
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 Yeah. Podaj mi piłkę.
Pedał pi.
Pedał pi. Next, what we're gonna learn is the basic of human relationship is good morning. Good morning means dzień dobry.
Dzień dobry.
Dzień dobry.
Dzień dobry.
Or you can say,
yeah, that's pretty
what's
easy.
Up?
What's up?
What's up?
What's up? How do you say coach?
Coach. 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 Coach is trener.
Trener. Centerare.
Nie tenterare. Trener. Trener.
Tenera.
No, it's simple to say. You see, you're talking about girls and you cannot use tongue. Basic stuff is like dzień dobry.
Dzień dobry.
And the most important for you, to me, podaj piłkę.
Podaj piłkę.
Pass me the ball. To 13. Ball.
The main two things.
And whatever. Okay.
Gotcha.
First three words, podaj mi piłkę, is to me, 13. Okay.
All right, gotcha.
Short, but I think really good Polish language lesson. What do you think?
It's pretty good.
Did you learn something?
I think I need to go to one of the other players to help me out. He wasn't too much help today.
No, nobody can help him. Thank you. Filip Dilevic, say goodbye, and
Marty Collins saying goodbye.
And goodbye in Polish language is do widzenia.
Say it again.
Say it again. Do widzenia.
Co z jęga?
Do widzenia. Nie, don't do it. Jęga is not here. Do widzenia. Do widzenia.
Co z jęga?
Do widzenia.
You can teach me off camera. Okay. Yeah.
Cut. Ciao. Bye.
He has long been among the premier big men in the Turkish Airlines Euroleague. On Thursday, Ioannis Borussis recorded his best performance since he joined Real Madrid last season, and in the process became the B-Win MVP for regular season round 10. Borussis starred for Madrid in its 90-70 victory over Anadolu Efes Istanbul to clinch first place in Group A. He finished with 19 points, 10 rebounds, 3 assists, 2 steals and 1 block for a performance index rating of 31, the highest of any player on a winning team in the last week of the regular season. The former All-Euroleague centre has twice previously taken weekly MVP awards, once last season and once in 2009. Ioannis Borussis, the B-Win MVP for regular season round 10. Now let's check out the last top 5 plays of the regular season.
Number 5, Madrid, Spain. Rudy Fernandez looking for a route through the FS defense. He finds it with the most audacious of passes, exquisitely played through his legs to Ioannis Borussis. Number 4, Athens, Greece. FC Barcelona in possession. Floor general Marcelinho Huertas sends up the high pass, and Mario Hezonja, an incredible leap to throw down a spectacular reverse alley-oop slam. Number 3, Lubin, Poland. The ball comes to Chris Wright, and look at him go! Nothing is going to stop him from unleashing an unstoppable monster dunk. Number two, Kaunas, Lithuania. Time running out on Žalgiris' season. They need a basket. James Anderson goes through a foul to score and tie with 2.5 seconds remaining. Incredible play from Anderson, who then scored the free throw to give his team the win. And look at what it means. And the number one play of the week from Tel Aviv, Israel, Jeremy Pargo going up, and look at that incredible, spectacular 360-degree mid-air spin, a thing of beauty.